Dun-dun-dun-dun! What's up guys? Welcome back to yet another video. This is Redmi 8A, and in this video I'm going to show you some of the tips and tricks that you can apply to customize your Redmi 8A. Now if you are new to my channel, don't forget to click on that subscribe button and hit that like button as well if you enjoyed watching this video. Alright, some tips and tricks that helps you customize Redmi 8A. For example, as you are seeing, this is the typical classic home screen that you get when you actually boot for the first time. Obviously you'll be having this kind of home screen. Now how do I change this to this? So in order to change that, go to settings here, and here you'll find additional settings, and inside additional settings, accessibility, and here you should find display size. This is where you want to change from small to extra small. Now pretty much everything is extra small here, which means the icon size, even the text size, and whatever you browse will be on the extra small size. And this gives you some look like a full HD plus screen. As you can see, the screen real estate itself has become a little bit better, so that you can browse more things and you can actually see more things in just one page itself. If I open the Chrome browser, as you are seeing, there are a lot of contents just covered in one single page. So this is how you can change the display size and get that full HD plus like virtual resolution. As you can see, all the interface here looks a bit small, and that gives you full HD plus resolution. So this was a little trick. Hit that like button if you like this one. The second one is to assign power button to end the call. Let's say you are calling to some person, or some person has called you, you are talking, and you just want to hang up the call, or rather disconnect the call very quickly. All you have to do is just press the power button to disconnect the call. So how to assign that function? Again, we will go to settings here, and inside the settings again we will go to accessibility. Here you'll find power button ends the call. So here's the option, power button ends the call. So by default it will be off, just turn that on. So the next time you are on the call, you can just press the power button to end the call. That's again a little trick. The third one is how to blur the application previews. Let's say I have opened a couple of applications, and if I just go to recent screen, as you can see, I have enabled the setting, and hence you can't see what I was actually going through the Chrome browser here. So how to enable this one? In order to do that, again we will go to settings quickly, and here you will find home screen, which is located here. Tap on home screen, and here you should find blur apps. So blur app previews, just tap on this one, and to whatever application you want, you can actually blur the application while you tap this recent screen. Let's say I'll show you exactly what's going on. For example, for the contacts, as you are seeing the dial numbers here very clearly, but you can't see what's going on in the Chrome browser, right? So if I just disable the Chrome switch here, like if I just tap on recent, again you can see what I was actually browsing through the Chrome here. So in order to blur these previews, you have to enable, or rather switch on, all the toggles here. So just like this, and whenever you just go to recent screen, whatever you are doing, you just can't see what was that. So that's a little privacy setting here, which is located in the home screen. I always suggest you to enable this blur app preview. Alright, I hope you liked that setting. The next one is regarding the notch and status bar. So let's go to settings and display quickly. So here's the display, and here you'll find notch and status bar. Now there are a lot of things that you can customize over here, but we will look at the notification shared shortcut. Now this is a little trick I always enable. Just go to this one and tap on search. By default it will be settings here. So what is this basically is, if I just go to the notification panel here, and here you'll see the settings, right? By default you will see the settings mark here. Now we have the settings icon here. Again, why this settings here, right? So instead of that settings, we will go to this notch and status bar, and we will make this one search. Now what this basically does is, wherever you are on the screen, just swipe down like this, and here you should be able to see search icon. Just tap on it, and pretty much whatever you want to search, you can just use this one and search. So basically it's a browser, or rather you can Google search instantly. So this is just a quick way of going through search instead of going to settings. Just swipe down like this, just tap on this one, and whatever you wanted to search, you can just go ahead and do that. That's a little trick over there. So you have to enable it from the notch and status bar. So the next trick is inside the developer option. So first let's enable the developer option. So in order to do that, just go to settings, and here you will see about phone. Just tap on that one and tap on MIUI version for like 6 to 7 times. Just keep tapping, and then the developer gets enabled. So you will find it in additional settings. So I'll just tap on additional settings, and here you'll find developer options. tap on that, and here you should see background process limit. So here it is, background process limit. By default it will be standard limit. I would suggest you keep at most 3 processes or 4 processes. What this basically does is it does not let any applications run in the background, like more than 3 if you have selected, and that will help you give more battery backup and also perform faster. So I would suggest you keep to 3 or 4 processes. You can always select no background process. That means whenever you go through any app and just take back, so no application will be running in the background. So that way you can set, again it's a personal preference, I would suggest you keep it to 3 or 4 processes. And let me know in the comment section down below how the mobile is performing when you set that. Alright, the next one is regarding battery optimization. There is a little trick over here which you need to enable. So let's go to battery and performance, and just tap on this settings icon here, and here you'll see clear cache when device is locked. This is also very nice trick. If you don't know, now you can actually enable this one. By default it will be like never, clear cache when device is locked. What this basically does is it clears the cache memory and makes RAM more space. That means your mobile will perform a little bit faster than before. So by default it will be never. I would suggest you change it to in 10 minutes. As you can see, I have done that. So after 10 minutes, automatically when the device is locked, after 10 minutes the cache memory gets cleared, and that will help mobile perform faster. Alright guys, this is it in this video. There are so many other settings and features which I'll cover in another video, because the video gets lengthy, as you guys know. You probably feel bored watching through all the settings in just one video. So we will keep some of the tricks to another video. Till then, hopefully you liked this one. So make sure you go ahead and change all the settings I showed. And don't forget to hit that like button, share it with your friends. And if you liked, please subscribe to my channel. Alright guys, I will see you all in another one. Till then, take care. Bye bye.